And welcome to the 12th of September. It is Saturday and there's a lot going on this morning. It's early, but up early. I have stripped my bed. There we go. Everything's kind of sitting like this just now. And I have cleaned my bathroom. And this is what's going on in here. There we go. My new cardi from Primark, which I love. Okay, this is what's going on. And this is what it looks like out there. Dreary. But we are getting ready to go and visit our family in Milton Keynes. It is Theo's birthday this week, so we thought we'd surprise him. But it's now not a surprise, but I'll tell you all about that once I'm in the car and I've got more time. I really need to get organised. This trip has turned out to be not as easy as we had planned. Again, I'll get into all of that when we get into the car because I have to really get myself organised. So I've got the washing in the washing machine, the bedding. So I'm going to get that dried back onto the bed, nice and fresh and clean for George and Ruth. To get all this packed, I think I'm just going to put all the clothes in suit bags, which will make it easier. I think what I'll do is I'll take my Keepall, is what I'll do. I'll get that down. It's my picnic blanket. Move that out of the way. My picnic basket. Right, let's get this down. And I'll put everything else in there. Shoes, bags, all the bits and pieces, jammies, underwear, I'll put in there. But our clothes I'll just put in suit bags, which will make life easier. So this is the Keepall. So get that out. Hasn't been out at all this year because we have been absolutely nowhere. So I need to have got it all packed up. So I need to empty everything out if I've got it stuffed. When I say packed up, just got it stuffed. So get all the stuffing out there. Put the stuffing into it, the dust bag, to tidy it away and put all the bits and pieces in there. Oh, that's the tummy rumbling. Did you hear the tummy rumbling? I've got bits of tissue, so just trying to get everything tidied. I've got a rubbish bag there to empty all the bins. And my wonderful, wonderful Chanel Deauville tote. This is when I like to use an organizer, and I do this when I travel as well because it just makes finding things really, really easy. So I've got my Sarah wallet, I've got my cosmetic pouch, I've taken two pairs of glasses, my Fendi and my Celine. I have my little mini pochette there with all kind of my emergency things in it, inhaler, or, you know, just the bits and pieces I've done, what's in my mini pochette, I think many a time. But tissues, sanitizer, all of that's kind of in there. We travel thing with my eye solution for my contacts, and there's wipes and things in there as well. So if I need to touch my contacts, my eyes, I've got wipes and all that at hand. My agenda just here. I have a little brolly there. I have this sunblock, so it's like a dusting sunblock. So if I'm sitting in the car and the sun's out, I just dust that on. So I've got a brush and a mirror, some mints in there. I've got my mask in there. I need to show you these. These are the wee pouches that we get from Chanel when we order things online, you know, like your nail varnishes, cosmetic things, and they tend to put all the free samples in these. Well, I keep these, and now what I use them for is my masks. So I keep my spare masks in there, and then if it's my masks, my washable masks, I can put them back in there as well, and that means I don't contaminate anything else and that can get washed as well. So there's a little idea for you there. So that's my masks, my keys, some gum. I don't really chew gum. That was just in there. I don't chew gum anymore. It's something that I've completely stopped doing. I've got my Louis Vuitton key pouch, house keys, car key, my iPad, not my iPad, my laptop, which kind of is part of me these days. Then I've got my 6 key holder with the rest of my keys there. And then in the zipped part of my bag, I have, this is the Cartier pouch that you get, and I really like that it doesn't say Cartier on it until you open it up on the inside. So you normally get these when you buy something from Cartier, and if you don't, sometimes they run out of them, go back and ask for one because you will get it. But it just says Cartier there. So for somebody that doesn't know, just doesn't know. And in there, this is like what I put my jewellery in. Actually, in there is my little screwdriver for my love bangle. You know, just in case, you know, I'm that just in case person. So because we're away for a couple of days, I'd like to have that with me. And then if I want to take a spare pair of earrings or something, this is a very casual weekend. It's a weekend to play with the kids, so I'm not really not taking any extra jewellery apart from the jewellery that I wear. But this is a pouch that I can store it in as well. I think I've put a pair of Dior earrings in there just to have. Got these ones in which I find really, really comfortable. So I've just got them. These were a gift for my birthday from my friend Lux and Roses. Here I have all my bags, all my electrical things for my laptop and everything. I still need to put my charger in for my phone, that kind of 3-in-1 that charges my earphones and my Apple Watch and my phone. Here, this is the nail varnish addict that I am. This is really unnecessary because my daughter-in-law is a beauty therapist and she has a beauty room, and I'm sure I won't need any of this. But when you're a nail varnish addict, your nail varnishes have to come with you. So I've just got 3 of my, that's the red that I'm wearing, and then the 2 latest ones that I bought from Chanel. In here is all my kind of medical things, and an inhaler, estrogen, my steroid cream if I need it, bits and pieces like that. And I still need to put in, oh, and my contact lenses and solution, things like that. Still got to get my vitamins. In here is going to be all my cleansers, moisturizers, skincare, that kind of thing. Hair accessories. I'm going to take this just in case we go for a walk and I want to keep my camera, phone, bits and pieces like that. That's another just in case thing. So I thought that would be the best for that sort of thing. Love that bag. So I decided that's the bag that's going. That's what I'm thinking of going. The weather's supposed to be glorious down there, so all I'm taking is shorts and then the trousers that I'm wearing, and I'll take another spare pair of jeans because we always need to have jeans with us. Right here I have my makeup all packed and ready in there, and my brushes are all packed and ready in there to get put away in the keep-all. So now I'm going to get myself ready. We are ready to go. Quick outfit, top from H&M, Karen Millen jeans, and my new sandals from Primark, which cost me £3. And I have my cozy cardi from Primark as well. I'm hurrying. Okay, everything is tidied, bed is made, house is hoovered, and we are ready to go. Love leaving a spotless house. Perfect. So here we are in the car at long last. We've actually now arrived in England. So we've left Scotland and the weather is really starting to heat up. We left a little later than Rico had planned, but there's a reason for that. So Rico's saying 3 hours, but let me explain. We have Lily right here and Rico's right there. So the reason being, so we had planned to go down to Milton Keynes for Theo's birthday, and it was supposed to be a surprise for Theo. But what happened yesterday, Friday, Theo woke up and wasn't feeling well. Costa and Kelly were pretty sure it was croup because he has suffered suffered from that before, which is another type of virus, which tends to affect children rather than adults, although adults can be affected by it. But anyway, so, but the symptoms are also very, very similar to COVID, the virus. So what do you do? So anyway, Costa tried to book Theo a COVID test, which proved to be really quite hard to do. He eventually managed to get him tested, so he kind of drove further away, and by hook or crook, he managed to get Theo tested, and they said to him that the test would take 2 days. So we're like, oh, so that was yesterday, and we had planned to leave early this morning. Rico was still adamant that he was gonna go down. Costa had said, "Mum, I honestly don't think it is COVID. I certainly wouldn't have you coming down if I thought it was." But you know me, Mrs. Overly Cautious. So anyway, although they had told Costa that the test would take 2 days, which means that he would get the test back tomorrow, I was kind of sure it would come back today at some point, because I've had quite a few friends of mine that have had the test and they've always had it back within 24 hours. So I was quite optimistic that the test would come back today. So I kind of held back. I was getting things done. I was prepared for leaving. I got myself organised last night and then was doing the final touches this morning. And of course, you know, I love to do a last minute quick clean up of the house as well. But I was holding back, hoping the results would come through, and they did. The results came back and it was negative. And as soon as that result came back, I was ready. I was kind of ready to go. So that's the update of our situation. So yeah, it was a bit of do we go, do we not go. Rico was adamant. So Theo now knows that we are going, because when Theo was going for his COVID test, as you can imagine, he was quite upset by it. And Costa said to him, just to make him feel better, you know, your yam bapu are coming, you need to get the test. And he got the test, and we are extremely proud of him, because it's a nervous thing to do for anybody. But he says it was kind of all right, not bad. Costa had to actually do the test for him, so put that big long cotton bud thing down his throat and up his nose. And yeah, so we are very excited to celebrate Theo's birthday and very excited to see our babies. And look, Lily is here, and she has wind. Honestly, not very nice when you're all stuck in the car and Lily's got wind. Anyway, I have plenty of drinks to get me going, but I'm not taking too many because I'm not going to stop at any of the services to use, you know, unless I'm absolutely desperate and I'm going to wet myself. But I have here all my drinks ready. Look, and coffee, and more down here as well. Here we go. So organised. Rico also made me a little packed lunch, a high protein, low carbs packed lunch, and absolutely looks delicious. So it's like an antipasti type thing you made, wasn't it? Honestly, it really looks delicious. So if I get hungry, I'm all prepared. Rico has all these sweeties and chocolates things as well. But anyway, so that's the update, and that's the situation. So it all worked out pretty well. This is our road ahead, and you can really honestly feel the change in temperature already. So yeah, so we left a dreary Scotland and we're going to a sunny Milton Keynes to get the last of the sunshine. Okay, we have stopped for a wee break. Lily was getting restless. We've given her some water, you can hear her in the back. I'm going to take her for a wee walk just now.
Rico's off to the little boy's room because it's so much easier for men, isn't it? So there he's back again. Oh, his mask. Always. He came back to the mask. Okay, so the other update I wanted to update you on was lockdown issues. So, you know, there's been an increase of cases both in Scotland and in England. So lockdown rules have now changed as well. Luckily, we kind of fit into the scope of no more than six in a household. Okay, Lily. I'm going to have to take Lily. No more. She's getting a wee bit panicky as well because Rico's gone away. She does that when one of us goes away. I'm going to take you. Daddy's coming. So, yeah. So there's a maximum of six in England within one household, including children. Up here, again, it's... But in England, it's slightly different because it's more than six. For more than six households, but within one household. Anyway, in Scotland, it's again no more than six people in a household, although you can meet outside. So I've got a feeling I've told you all this already. Anyway, so we fit, we're okay. Basically, we're within the lockdown rules, so it's fine for us. So yeah, I better go and take Lily for a wee walk. I'll have a wee sip of coffee as well. That we're here again. I'm trying not to drink too many things. Oh, delicious, lovely. Okay, let me go and take Lily a little walk and make her feel a little better. And yeah, she's got her seatbelt on in the back. She's quite insecure. I think she likes to be held. Look. I don't know if you'll be able to see, but I don't know if you can see her, but there, she's looking for Rico. Okay. Let me take Lily out. So, that's us. Let's see what I look like. Oh, it's quite windy out there. But, yeah, Lily's had a pee-pee, Rico's had a pee-pee.
The route is in the indicated direction.
And even I had a pee-pee, but I was very much not touching anything. Tissues. I took my wet ones with me to touch the door, to open and close the door, and like my sanitizer, my big sanitizer goes with me everywhere. So now we're going to make up the time. It's okay. I've also got my packed lunch here that Rico made up for me. Yummy. So I've got some mixed cheeses, some mixed olives, and then some mortadella, which is really delicious, with some lettuce. And I'm actually looking forward to that. And I've even got a wee cheeky gin because we're on holiday. See, when you go on holiday and you go to the airport, you know, there's no timing in the airport. So if you arrive there in the morning, you have a wee cheeky alcoholic drink because it's part of your holiday. And this is part of my holiday. I just hope I don't need to drive, which I won't be once I take a super gin. That is it. No driving for me. But I never do these long distance things. Rico always does them. But yeah, so that's where we're at just now. And Lily is now in the back. We've strapped her in. She's in her seatbelt at the back. So, yeah.
We have, come here. We have arrived in Milton Keynes and we are also very excited because we are here to celebrate Theo's 7th birthday and it starts right now, doesn't it? It sure does, doesn't it?
After dinner.
No, the birthday's starting right now because we're here.
Yeah. But
no buts. It's your birthday and we're here to have fun. Sure we are.
I'm getting my birthday cake.
Look, and I've got
dinner.
Anna tapping at my leg. Yes, we see you, madam. We see you. What's this? Take this out. Pipila. No, 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 no. It didn't need pipila. You're a big girl.
Hi.
Say hello. What are you eating? So you had a pipila and something. You're chewing something in your mouth as well. Anna. Whose is this? This mine? Is this mine? Whose is this? This mine? You playing with Lily?
Yeah.
Whose is that? That's Mummy's phone.
I am 7.
You are 7?
Yeah.
Ah! What phone?
Theo! See when you went on your iPad?
an app for steps on it.
Yeah.
And when you were walking, could you see the steps?
No, because it doesn't work yet. Just got it.
Right, okay. Let me tell you something. Right, see, Hazard, it's your birthday from today.
Yeah.
Yeah. And you know how Mummy's got an Apple Watch and Daddy's got an Apple Watch?
Yeah.
And it records all their steps and everything.
Yeah.
I think that's why your iPad's not working, because you need a watch to record everything. And see, because it's your birthday, yeah, can you just put that down a minute, because this is what you need to record your steps. This is for your birthday.
Oh.
Okay, that's your watch. Okay, and it's going to record all your steps.
How does it connect to my iPad?
It's already connected, that's why you can see steps on it. Okay? That's why you can see steps on your iPad. There's the step app.
Because it's
for your watch.
How do you turn it on?
There you go. I think maybe Yaya's has put it on the wrong way around, maybe. Okay, so you can go and show your dad, and he's going to show you how it works. So that's from Yaya and Bubble for your birthday for today. But I'm sure you'll get something else on your actual birthday as well, okay? But this is so you know how you're worried about the time and all that? Well, now you can check all that on your watch, and so when you go swimming, it'll tell you all about your swimming and how many steps you've done. And
but then, is it waterproof?
It's water, of course it's waterproof! This is the special watch for Theo! Okay, and you can compare with Mummy how many steps she's done, with Daddy, and even with Yaya, and we'll see. And we can see who's done the most.
So, I done a step.
Alright, okay.
I done a step.
Okay, there's Daddy. He's going to show you exactly how it works.
Go
on.
Just say thank you very much.
Thank you very much.
So now that makes sense, doesn't it? Because you thought, why has that appeared on my iPad all of a sudden?
It's from the update.
So see if you go on this.
Yeah.
So see when you come on this.
Yeah.
That'll then match up to your watch. Okay. Yeah. So then as you walk around, when you come back, when you open this app,
yeah,
it'll update and it'll count your steps.
It's not doing the thing.
It will if you walk around some.
Okay.
Right, let's go. Let's go. Yeah. Riquella.
Hello.
Thank you.
Come in.
Theo, come on in.
That's some more robots.
Theo, quick.
One, two, three. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Theo. Happy birthday to you. Theo, was that a big surprise?
Anna, look, what's that?
Anna, are you ready? Anna, let's see because the steaks are going to go.
Anna.